nobody knows me. On the way, my eyes are on the lookout. Street phosphors, a sugarcane juice vendor, an aquarium display, three-story library with more stories than stairs, funnier hats on funny displays, and I will admit, I try some on. Small churches with new hour recitals and bells that ring at the hour. Once, I came across a bookstore turned superstore. I saw from their windows that there was enough space between the aisles, so I danced to indie pop between travel guides and poetry, sashayed a book of Leonard Cohen to health and well-being, and breathed my hallelujah there. When I arrived home again, there were no bags of purchases heavy on my shoulder, no plastic handles carving creases into the skin of my forearm just below the bend of my elbow. I carried in my left fingers only a small plastic box with a square paper at the bottom, stained red, which I tossed into the blue bin in the driveway. I am not sure exactly when I finished all the raspberries. I left my watch on the kitchen counter when I checked my bag before I left to make sure it was already full.